Hello friends, this is Anand Pai from Academy in Pursuit of Engineering Excellence. Today on Students' Recommendation, we will solve question 1 to 9 of XE Thermodynamics 2019. Let us start. The first question goes like this. 1 kg of ideal gas occupies a certain volume V at a temperature T and pressure P1. 4 kg of another gas is added to the first, keeping the volume V and temperature T same as before, the final pressure is. Now how the question is, let us understand. So there is a vessel of say volume V, and initially there is a pressure P1. So here I can say P1, okay, into V, that is a volume, is equal to, we can say R, that is the say universal gas constant, I can put it as bar, universal gas constant, divided by say molecular weight x, correct, into temperature T1 or temperature T. So we are keeping the temperature same, so temperature T. Now to this only we are adding more of the other gas which has molecular weight 2 times, but we are adding 4 kgs of that mass. See that. So now what happens, that new P2 into volume remaining the same, we are adding some more. And what is that we are adding? We are adding, first of all, we are adding the 4 times the mass. So we can write 4, okay, 4 times mass plus 1 mass is always there, okay, 1 kg of the other gas is there. So what is the, if I say R here, and this is temperature. So here, instead of multiplying 1 by x here, we are adding 1 by x and 4 by 2x, both we are adding here, okay. So this comes out to be equal to, when you add all these things, we get 3 by x into RT, this is P2V, and we know that if I say P2 is equal to 3 into RT into x by P, which is P1, okay, x by V, I'm sorry, x by V here, I'm very sorry here, x by V. So this RT by XV is actually P1. So what happens, this becomes P2 is equal to 3 into P1. So the answer is answer number B. So I hope you have understood this, students. Next question. Which of the following is an intensive thermodynamic property? The answer is intensive. Now what do you mean by intensive? Which depends on the intensity. What is the meaning of extensive, which depends on the extensive? There is a way by which we can get which is extensive and what is intensive. If I have a hole and the value of the property, property P, don't confuse it with pressure, so I'll put a property P like this, okay. So this property P, if the value of this property is equal to property for the whole, okay, the value of the property for the whole is equal to the sum of the values of the parts, then it is extensive. If the value of the property for the whole is same for all the parts, then it is intensive. Now here if I see which is intensive, enthalpy is not an intensive property. As the extent increases, enthalpy increases. Yes, enthalpy per unit mass is intensive. Similar way, internal energy or entropy are extensive property. But specific entropy, specific internal energy, these are all intensive property. So the answer is only pressure. P is equal to, the answer is D. Okay, next question. A thermodynamic process for a substance is represented as a constant pressure process on a PV diagram and a constant temperature process on a TV diagram. Which of the following statement is true? The substance is an ideal gas. Not clear? Correct? Ideal gas, we cannot say a process just based on ideal gas. The substance is van der Waals gas. Even it is not clear here, because a gas, just because it is a gas, doesn't ensure these two conditions. The substance undergoes phase change. This is a probable answer. Why? Because when phase change happens, both the pressure and the temperature remains constant. Correct? So when there is a phase change happening, the pressure in the, when it is changing the phase, the pressure as well as the temperature changes. So the answer is C. You see, next one. Addition of a reheat process to a simple Rankine cycle always A, increases both efficiency and work output of a cycle, increases the efficiency but not necessarily work output, increase work output but not necessarily efficiency, decrease both efficiency and work output. Let us see what is the answer. Now first let us understand what is reheat. When I say reheat, reheat is whenever there is a process in a Rankine cycle. See, here is the compression process, or say heat condenser. Then we have, we can say here there is a pump, okay, and then boiler, superheater, okay. Now what happens in a reheat cycle? A reheat cycle, the same thing happens is you come till the saturation point and then you again heat it, correct? Saturated this one, you heat it, you superheat again and then you come down. This is reheat. So now when reheat happens, okay, whether increase in the work output happens, obviously yes, because the work output happens in two phases. One is over here, another one is here. If I say 1 and 2 and 3 and 4, in both 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 there is work which is output. But now what about efficiency? Now efficiency, Carnot efficiency or anything, depends on the temperature. Okay, if I say just Carnot efficiency, although it is not just Carnot efficiency, so if I say Carnot efficiency, we can say it is T1 by T2. This is a higher temperature, or you can say T2 by T1, I'm sorry here. So T2 is a high, lower temperature, T1 is a higher temperature. So this determines the efficiency. Now efficiency can be increased generally in the Rankine cycle or any cycles by increasing the mean temperature of heat addition. What can we do? We can increase the mean temperature of heat addition. But here we cannot be sure that the mean temperature of heat addition increases, and that is why we cannot be sure about the efficiency. Okay, so reduction below this also increases the efficiency. If I reduce T2, if I say this is T2 and if I say this is T1, okay, or this is T1, okay, so my mean, reducing the condenser temperature increases the efficiency better than increasing the heat addition temperature. But still, reducing the condenser temperature is not viable in Rankine cycle. So increasing the increasing the mean temperature of heat addition is a more viable option. But here that we cannot ensure, okay, that the mean temperature of heat addition increases. Okay, so that is the reason the answer would be C. Increase work output but not necessarily the efficiency of the cycle. Next, Carnot cycle implemented using an ideal gas in a piston cylinder system will have work transfer in two parts of a cycle and heat transfer in other two parts, work transfer in all four parts of a cycle and heat transfer in two parts of the cycle, work transfer in two parts of the cycle and heat transfer in all four parts of the cycle, work transfer in all four parts of the cycle and heat transfer in four parts of the cycle. Now what is the answer for this? Now here, if I consider what is Carnot cycle, Carnot cycle has two types of thing. There are two isothermal processes and two adiabatic processes, and we are sure that in adiabatic process there is no heat transfer, so no heat transfer in adiabatic process. But in isothermal process there is no temperature increase, and in isothermal process there is both heat addition, heat transfer as well as work transfer. Okay, so what is the thing? It is work transfer in all the four parts of the cycle and heat transfer in two parts of the cycle is the right answer. Answer is B here. Okay, next one. The degrees of freedom for a pure substance at its triple point is. Now when you say degrees of freedom, what does it mean? Degrees of freedom means the number of ways we can change it so that the state does not change. The state in the sense how it looks does not change. Now what do you mean by triple point? Triple point means you have ice, that is solid, water, liquid, and steam, gas, in equilibrium with each other. That means the amount of quantity does not change of steam, liquid, or solid, that is ice. So this is one way of seeing it. And triple point is a specific point there. It happens at a particular pressure, particular temperature, and particular pressure and temperature. That's it. Okay. So it cannot be reproduced. If you change a bit of temperature, a bit of pressure, the state changes. Okay. So the number by that only we can know that the degrees of freedom is zero. But there is another thing. There is something called Gibbs phase rule. Gibbs phase rule comes from material science. So degrees of freedom, DOF, is actually equal to C minus P plus 2. What is C? Number of components, number of chemical components, 1 there, correct? Minus number of, number of phases, 3, and number of plus 2, so that is equal to 0. So the answer is D. Next one. The differential of a Gibbs function G for a simple compressible system can be represented as dg is equal to vdp minus sdt. Using the appropriate Maxwell relation derived from the equation, the quantity minus dou s by dou p at constant T for an ideal gas is. What are the options? Let us see. Now first of all, we have to understand the exact and inexact differential. It is like any differential, any differential, if you say dz, can be written as mdx plus ndy. And here this is an exact differential means this z should be a property. Okay, so if this is an exact differential, then dou m by dou y is equal to dou n by dou x. Okay, now if I consider this comes as z, this comes as m, this comes as x, this comes as n minus s comes as n, and this comes as dy. So putting dm by dy dou m by dou y, that is at constant x, and dou n by dou x at constant y. Okay, let us do the Maxwell's relation here. Dg is a property, Gibbs function is a property, so it is an exact differential. So if I do this, dou m is that dou, instead of m I am putting v, and then instead of y what should I put? T. Dou m by dou t, so dou v by dou t at constant pressure, y is p, plus into dx. Dx is what? That is not required. This is equal to, now dou n, what is dou n? Dou n is dou s, and what dou s? Minus dou s. Is it not? There is minus there. So minus dou s divided by minus dou s divided by dou p at constant temperature. So they have given the hint here. So this, since they have given the hint and we get the same thing, so we have dou v by dou t of p is equal to minus dou s by dou p. This is the relation we have to have. Next, we have to see the ideal gas. It is given for an ideal gas, it is asked there for an ideal gas. For an ideal gas, PV is equal to RT. So if I say dou V by dou T, let us say, P is a constant, so P into dou V is equal to R into dou T, or dou V by dou T at constant pressure is equal to R by. Now we know that this minus dou s by dou p is equal to dou v by dou t at constant p, and that is equal to R by p. So the answer is B, R by p. Hope it is clear. Next one. A Carnot engine receives 2000 kilojoules heat from a source at 1200 Kelvin and rejects 500 kilojoules heat to the sink. The sink temperature is. Now here we have to see the thermodynamic scale of temperature, and in thermodynamic scale of temperature, it is said that the amount of heat added or heat rejected by a Carnot engine, irrespective of the material to be chosen, is equal to the temperature, that is the absolute temperature. The Kelvin what we have is the thermodynamic temperature scale, where the temperature does not depend on the material used in the engine. It should be reversible, and it should, and all the reversible engines at that temperature rejects or receives the same amount of heat. Okay, this is what is it. So what is happening here is the temperature is proportional to the heat rejected or heat added or heat rejected. So that is why now efficiency, when I say it, is 1 minus Q heat rejected by heat added. Now this can be written as 1 minus T2 by T1. Although some things might have a proportionality, that gets cancelled here. So it is 1 minus T2 by T1. So now these are same. So 1 minus Q2 by Q1 is equal to 1 minus T2 by T1. So this is equal to 1 minus Q2 is given as 500 divided by Q1 is given as 2000. That is equal to 1 minus T2 is given as, I don't know, we do not know that T2, we do not know, T1 is 1200. When we solve this, we get answer T2 is equal to 300 Kelvin. So this is the answer. So the answer is 300 Kelvin. I hope you have understood this, students. Next one. A closed vessel contains a pure substance with 0.1 meter cube of saturated liquid and 0.9 meter cube of saturated vapor. The specific volume of the liquid and vapor phases are 0.000843 meter cube per kg and 0.2671 meter cube per kg respectively. The percentage of vapor in the mixture on a mass basis rounded off to two decimal places is. Now let us see that. Now first of all, V of F, it is generally Vf in a sense the liquid, okay, is 0.1 meter cube, and V of G, that is the gas, is 0.9 meter cube. Now if I consider in terms of specific volume, what is specific volume? Specific volume is mass, sorry, volume per mass, right? Volume per mass. This is the volume, I'm sorry, here it is given, okay? Pure substance contains, so this is capital V, I'll say, and this also capital V, okay? So specific volume is volume per mass, or volume is equal to mass into specific volume. So now if I consider this, my mass, okay, of MF into specific volume of F is equal to 0.1 meter cube. From this I can get MF, if I substitute F for the liquid, that is 0.0083 here, okay, substitute 0.000843 meter cube per kg. And when we solve it, I will get it as equal to 118.623 kgs. Similar way, here we can write this as, here we have MF into VF. So here I can write MG into VG, that is gas, is equal to 0.9 meter cube. Okay. So this way, if I solve VG, I am substituting as 0.02671. If you substitute that, we will get MG is equal to 33.695. So many kgs. Okay. So the total on the percentage of vapor, that means percentage of vapor on mass basis is percentage of vapor on mass basis is actually equal to, I can say, MG divided by MF plus MG. Correct, into percentage when you say, you have to say 100. Okay, so if I apply this, this is 33.695 divided by 118.673 plus 33.695 into 100, we will get the answer as 22.12%. So this is the answer. So answer is 22.12%. So these are the questions in thermodynamics which we have solved. I hope you have understood this, students. Kindly give me the feedback, whether I was fast, whether I was slow, or whether it's proper. any type of feedback. And also in any any gate problem or any competitive exam, if you have any questions which you are not able to solve or which you want me to do a top video on, please tell me. It can be on a topic also. Okay, you can suggest me a topic on which I have to do a video and I'll be doing it. So kindly subscribe my channel and click the bell icon so that you'll get the notifications. And thank you very much, students. All the best for your exams.